Today, Nobert Mao appeared before Parliament's Committee of Human Rights to respond to recommendations of the annual human rights report. Mao called on Parliament to press government to clear the backlog of these conversations, which are on the neck of the Ugandan Human Rights Commission.
Parliament to also play its role of oversight because some of these cases are very sensitive and pressure from Parliament can help.
Mao informed the committee that Uganda police was tasked with the responsibility of verifying victims of November 2020 riots.
A matter that requires further engagement because I know, for instance, that the National Unity Platform tabled a list to which the government did not respond in a satisfactory manner. The government neither denied nor confirmed. But for us, we believe that the Uganda police, because they are the ones who carry the bodies of victims to the mortuaries, would have a more accurate database.
Mao has promised to engage the National Security Council to secure the freedom of the alleged political prisoners that have been incarcerated in several detention facilities since elections of 2021.
One is about the case of Honorable Seginya and Sewanyana. Their case has been adjourned for so long. It's always adjournment, adjournment, adjournment. I am really glad that you're in that seat right now, and I would particularly request that you take special interest, personal interest in this case, so that we bring it to its logical conclusion. What exactly is the challenge? Why are they still being held? It's now coming to 8 months. These are our colleagues that are still in prison without any specificities given to the case.
Political prisoners, those detained, we are working with the other agencies. Now, I need the committee to note that there's a body in Uganda known as the National Security Council, and their opinion is very important in some of these cases. I won't come here and pretend that I know exactly the details of those cases. I don't want to say more because these cases are in court, many of them. But for the cases that are not in court, I think it is our duty to deal with them because there is no way we can accept a citizen of Uganda just to be disappeared. Actually, I'm more concerned about the disappearances because when you are disappeared, anything can happen to you. Nobody will know what has happened to you.
He has also committed to give justice to the new party president, Robert Kyagulayi Sentamu, and the Mitiania municipality MP, Francis Zake, who was allegedly tortured in Arua during parliamentary by-election of 2018.
Robert Kyagulayi was tortured and detained. None other than the deputy speaker of parliament went to see him. And he came out openly and said, the Honorable MP is in great pain. Obviously, the pain must have been caused. I do believe that the key is not to condone these things. That is really the key. Because torture has no political color.
Mao has also pledged to set up a special standing committee in cabinet on human rights to help in fostering matters of human rights in government and also set up an annual human rights review exercise in government. Meanwhile, the chairperson of the Electoral Commission, Simon Biabakama, has described the episodes of violence that marked the recently concluded Soroti City East by-election as unfortunate and condemnable. Members of the Parliamentary Committee of Human Rights had no kind words for the Electoral Commission regarding the recently concluded by-election. MPs put the Electoral Commission chairperson, Simon Biabakama, to task to explain whether the Electoral Commission was in charge of the process.
And 40 supporters of the FDC and leaders were already arrested, and by end of the following day, more than 90 supporters, 50 of them were leaders, were arrested. Not anyone of the leaders from the other political party were competing with was arrested, to suggest that the only people who committed crimes according to the police were the FDC.
Oh, accept other things that you are also seeing it is wrong. You accept it to take it. Why?
Put his title. I heard the same with you, Honorable. Say, even your children, as you're telling Todong, even your children must be ashamed. This thing is we need to be firm. You know your profession.
Would ever dare to change any results or mess during elections. I want to encourage you to counsel your staff, to talk to them, to tell them do not ever, whether you put what kind of money, people put more than a billion down, leave that alone, the fatigue up to now. Most of you know my voice. I've lost my voice totally. I used to speak like this girl who has just been pulled from the choir. I can no longer have that voice.
However, the Electoral Commission chairperson, Simon Biabakama, told the Committee of Human Rights that election violence in Soroti East was regrettable and condemnable.
Some of the episodes we witnessed in Soroti were most unfortunate. They are condemnable. For example, as I said, my deputy chairperson was almost lynched. She was attacked, and yet she was carrying out her lawful duty by visiting a polling station to find out how things were going on. In one of the polling stations, the box was smashed by one of the candidates. He kicked it, and the box was rendered inoperable. So these were unfortunate episodes, and so on.
The Committee of Human Rights faulted the Electoral Commission for causing a by-election in Soroti East through unlawful demarcations of constituency boundaries.
Explain a loss of a colleague just because of demarcation. I want to understand from you, who is responsible for demarcation?
The Electoral Commission also threw it to courts of law, which gave contradicting orders on demarcation disputes between Soroti East Division and Soroti West Division. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.